Hello?
Hello. We're the safety twins.
I'm Stop.
And I'm Go.
And we have stopped
to ask you to go to a party.
A party? What kind of party?
Jump.
Mother, a letter for Bobby and Billy. Hooray! A birthday party! You boys will need to buy a gift. And don't forget those manners. Oh boy, party favors! And refreshments. Everybody's having fun. What are you up to, Billy? Must be pooped. Good to see you didn't shirk your duty. And don't forget those manners.
This top's really itchy. I'm not sure about showing my upper arms.
Looks nice, though. Well, this skirt keeps riding up a bit short.
Looks nice, though. I look like Dick Henry in these shoes.
I'll have to pin this top to the belt. God, the belt's too tight.
These tights are sagging at the crotch.
They look nice, though.
It's my eyeliner smudge.
It's mine.
You there. What do you want?
We've come to the party.
You're a bit early.
The disastrous date. Who is Dog Boy and how did he come to be?
It's gotta get yanked.
So why not a dog heart?
And now with his dog heart beating wildly in his chest, Dog Boy is out the door to work at Po Dunk's Diner.
Whoa, calm down. Just ignore that stupid cat. If you chase it, you'll never make that train.
Late again, Dog Boy. That's the third time this week. You better hustle your ass, dude. We're gonna need those dishes for the lunch run.
You keep coming in late and you're gonna get canned. What's your excuse this time?
I was busy chasing something.
Chasing something? What? Chasing a little tail?
Well, sort of.
Sort of?
Sort of.
Man, oh man, you must have put on quite a performance, man, Dog Boy.
Speaking of which, check this thing out. A big old ham bone. Now come and get it.
Come on, you guys, leave me alone. You're not very funny.
Hey, do I look like a comedian? Now come and get it.
I'm not even going to listen to you anymore.
So out the door she walks.
Hey, you. Yeah, blamo. Where the hell you think you're going? Huh? We got a cover charge here.
Cover charge?
Yeah, that's right, Einstein. It's going to set you back about 10 clams for you and your lady friend.
Clams?
Jail, babe.
Gee, I'm kind of thirsty. Shall I get us both a drink?
Okay, but hurry right back, because I think the show is starting soon.
I swear I ain't gonna bother no more, Mr. George. I ain't gonna bother none 50.
I can't see a thing. I'll never find Betty. Oh, wait a minute. I bet I can still find her.
I ain't gonna miss another 18. I'm gonna need her 20 almonds alone, too.
All right, you pencil neck geek. Get up.
Nobody sniffs my girl's butt except me. Say goodnight, bonehead.
Come on, Dog Boy. I know you want it. Now come and get it.
Let me just see it for a second.
You gotta beg for it.
That's right. Get down and beg.
How's this?
That's a good boy. Now, speak.
What the hell's going on here? Where's my patty melt and pronto platter?
Don't bust a vein, Rondi. We were just watching Dog Boy perform.
Dog Boy? Kind of cute name. Gee, Dog Boy, you're really working on that bone. What other doggy tricks you got up your sleeve? You know, sometime when you're not too busy sniffing fire hydrants, we could step out, have a little fun.
Yeah.
I'll talk to you later, Dog Boy.
Whoa! She's off the trot. She wants your ass.
Go for it. Oof.
Quit razzing me, you guys. All you ever think about is dirty stuff. I mean, really, Rondi seems like a nice girl.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
What disastrous deeds lie ahead for the dumbfounded Dog Boy? Find out next time. See Rondi the Ravishing Waitress's devious plans to dominate Dog Boy.
You promised to take me on a date.
I did?
That's right, Big Boy.
See Dog Boy being surreptitiously spied on by Mr. Murdoch, the nauseating next-door neighbor.
I'm telling you, Helen, that guy is a ding-dang psycho or something.
Hear Mrs. Murdoch's moans of uninhibited delight as she is healed by Jerry, her personal television savior.
Oh, Jerry.
Be there.
Dog, go to a neighboring house to obtain a clue, but our heroes are disintegrated, or something like that.
What did you do to them, Dr. Denwright?
As far as Mastermind and his cohorts can tell, nothing has happened. But in reality, they are now in a parallel universe.
That doesn't sound so bad.
Yes, but there is one small difference. That other universe is composed of antimatter. They're all yours, Dr. Antimatter Dendrite.
Thank you. And may I say that it has been a pleasure to play with myself.
You see, Delilah, when matter and antimatter meet, they are both destroyed. So, when the antimatter mastermind comes into contact with our mastermind, kablooey!
Oh, Doctor, you're such a man.
Yes. Well, this would be a good time to check with our heroes.
Hey, we're still kicking.
Nothing gets past you, Muscles. All right, mastermind, how do we get out of here?
We're in great danger.
You're telling me? You trying to give us the flu or something?
I'm allergic to only one thing, antimatter.
I don't get it.
Get out of the way. Oh, no.
Ayah! It's us!
Don't. If you touch yourselves, you'll both cease to exist.
I thought it was we'd go blind or something.
Look upon this face before I dispose of you forever.
What's this guy Dendrite's beef with you?
Raoul Dendrite and I were roommates in college. I tried to help him with some complex calculations. He didn't listen and a bad thing happened.
There was an accident and he was disfigured for life?
Worse, he was audited.
What's next? We can't hang around forever.
I wouldn't worry about that.
It's up to me now. If I can only slow down the gears.
It's slim, but it just might work. If it doesn't, both universes could be erased.
That would be bad, right?
Best not to ask.
If anyone out there knows what has happened, please tell me. Meanwhile, I'll have to wait for the next episode of The Specialist Don't Bank on It. But that's the title.
Beanie!
Franco!
Beanie!
Gemma!
Beanie!
Charles!
Beanie!
Sally!
So, what are you doing?
Where's Malcolm, then?
In bed. I mean, I just feel if I'm going to have children, I'd better hurry up.
Yeah, do you come? It'd be really, really cute.
People are using the small plates for the couscous and there
Where's
for the cake.
Malcolm?
In bed.
Basically, I'm an express lift.
Yeah, no. Oh, Jesus, someone's eating the cake already.
So sorry to offend you.
Are you comfortable? Are you comfortable? Are you comfortable?
You know, it doesn't get any better than this.
Comfortable? Are you comfortable?
No.
Are you comfortable?
It doesn't get any better than this.
Are you
It doesn't
comfortable?
Get comfortable. Are you any better than this?
Better get comfortable.
It doesn't
you know
get
better.
Better comfortable.
Get comfortable. Better than
Are you
know
any better,
better
than this?
You know better.
What am I so afraid of?
Jesus!
Afraid? I think.
So what?
Love.
Afraid.
I think I love.
So what?
I think.
Afraid.
Everything is beautiful. Everybody in its own way.
So what? Not afraid?
Like a starry summer night. Snow-covered winters.
What's your name?
Rose.
You have a nice, strong arm. You like to jig?
Oh, Franco, I'm so drunk.
Very sexy.
Hey, Binny, where's Malcolm?
In bed, for God's sake.
I'm my own person, you know.
Oh, Christ, Binny's got a knife.
Oh, Christ, Binny. Excuse me, my father's an osteopath.
No one likes me.
I like you, Binny. I like your eyes.
We all like you, Binny.
Better go then.
With parties, I don't really know what it is I'm after.
No. Say goodnight, Bonehead.
Thank you.
Beach MTV with Daisy Fuentes, because it's more than sandcastles and crabs, honey.